horses on New Year's Eve, walking down my Brooklyn street. And I saw fireworks in your eyes. I was falling, falling, falling 1 year ago at this time. Now I'm trying, trying, trying to get back my mind. I'll take my photographs, wrap them in bubble wrap. I'm leaving for the weekend, or maybe for the year. I'll secure all my edges, all the fragile remarks that were taken the wrong way.
Here's my solar, here's my battery meter hooked up here. It's showing that I'm at 12.9 volts. You can see the solar is panel is putting in about 3-4 amps. And the battery, which was pretty low, is about 90% full. So the solar comes in through inside there, where this light is. It shares the same conduit and comes down to the controller. We've got these LED lights wired up on the ceiling. I set them to any color you want. I have the inside wall down here, the lower part below the counter. This will be out of sight. If you're wondering, don't I know better than to use sheetrock in an RV? Yes, I do know better. I'm doing it anyway and see how it works. Sheetrock over here also. This is behind that. Well, I've got that construction paper in front of it. This is all going to be hidden and not seen. So it's a little, we'll see how it works. I think it's going to be okay. Propane is coming in up here. That valve there shuts off the propane going to the water heater, and also the propane going to the range hookup, which is right there. That's just a temporary cap off. And the sink is going to go here. And we've got a 12 volt for the 12 volt cooler and an extra. These are both dedicated outlets. And then there's a 110 down there. The water heater is both electric and propane. So its connection goes into here. I've got my panel here, mainly wired. These are all 12 volt circuits down here. 110 is up here. And everything comes through. Here's the back of it. Everything comes through here, down here, and then this terminal box is for the 12 volt. Everything's running in conduits. We've got a bunch of different kinds of conduit. This blue stuff is the normally what you'd normally use for 12 volt. I ended up running some of it inside this other flex conduit because I had some of it and whatever, blah, blah. And for the most part, the 110 is for the most part running in this flex metal conduit.
There was a crack in the plan when the chaos began in the old house sitting on the corner. There was a table set for four, and a family of three still waiting for the return of their past brother. Still waiting for the return of their past brother. There was a fighter in the ring who'd forgotten how to swing, thinking thoughts of his dear mother. When the The farmer left his land to develop a new plan, to drop everything and search for his last lover.
The back of the circuit breaker here has this special outlet, which I have, it's got a dedicated breaker for that. And that outlet plugs in here, and it's just a 12 gauge extension cord. I ran along, this ceiling will eventually be covered, but it comes over to here, to this outlet with a switch on it. It's off now, but if I turn that on, that will turn on the battery charger, and then the battery charger connects to these terminals here, which go down to the battery downstairs. The inverter is right here, and this is also hooked up to the battery. Of course, we don't want to run both the inverter and the charger at the same time, which is why I have the switch there. And the switch for the inverter is right there. And then the inverter outlet goes through this cord, and it comes back over to here. It comes back over to here, and this is an auto transfer switch down here. So if the inverter is on, and I forgot to turn it off, but plug the bus in, this will automatically switch between the two. So when I plug the bus in, it's a 30 second delay, but it'll kick in the shore power. Then the outlet from outside comes in right here, and that also goes to the auto transfer switch. And then the output for the auto transfer switch comes up here to this box and then routes through right there. And then similarly, the battery itself comes in here and then feeds the 12 volt circuits. And it's raining like crazy outside. I don't know if you can hear it. I was at a festival a few months ago in the bus, and about midnight Saturday night, it started just pouring down rain. Everybody in the tents were scrambling. I was nice and dry in my hippie school bus.